Hi, it's Carly McAvoy talking about converting standard units of volume and time. And this is the chart that has all the conversions in it that we're going to be using in the next few videos. And then I'm going to work these six problems, and I'm going to use the unit conversion method where we set up a fraction that's equal to one. So for instance, I might say if I wanted a fraction that involved this conversion, that would be equal to 1, I could say that 1 ton over 2,000 pounds, because that equals 1, because 1 ton is equal to 2,000 pounds. So it's like multiplying by 1. That's what unit conversions actually mean. So in the first one, I'm going to take 150 minutes, and I'm going to change that into seconds. And so what I do is I put the original unit that I have, and I put that over 1, and I multiply by that unit fraction. In this case, I want to go from minutes to seconds. So the minutes I put on the bottom and the seconds I put on the top. And the reason I put the minutes on the bottom is because I want those two things to cancel. So I put one on top and one on bottom. But what's the conversion? Well, there's 60 seconds in 1 minute. And then I would just multiply 150 times 60, and that would give me 9,000 seconds. So this is the conversion, 9,000 seconds in 150 minutes. What about the second one? Well, in the second one, I have 35 cups, and I want to change that into quarts. I don't have a direct conversion for that. I have cups into pints, and I have pints into quarts. So I'm going to do this in two steps. 35 cups, I want to get rid of cups, and in the first step, I want to go from cups to pints. So I'm going to change this to pints. I'm going to say in 1 pint, there's 2 cups. And then I'm going to do the second stage, and that is I'm going to get rid of pints and change into quarts. So in this case, I have 1 quart is 2 pints. That's the conversion that's given. So I'm multiplying essentially by 1, and then I'm multiplying by 1 again. So I'm not really changing anything. I'm just changing the unit that we can use here. So I have 35 divided by 4 essentially, and that gives me cups went and pints went, and that gives me the quarts, and I'm going to just rewrite that as 8.75 quarts. In the next one, I'm changing 32 fluid ounces to cups, and so I put this over 1. I want to get rid of fluid ounces on the bottom and change that into cups, and then I'm going to say that 1 cup has, and I can look at my chart, 8 fluid ounces. And so then the fluid ounces cancel, leaving cups, and 32 divided by 8 would be 4, so I would get 4 cups. In the next problem, I'm saying 87 hours to days and hours. So I start off with 87 hours. Put that over 1. I know that I want to get rid of hours, that goes on the bottom, and days on the top, and I know that there's 24 hours in a day, and so then I can do this, 87 divided by 24. Now you want to be careful here, because if you take 87 and divide by 24, your hours are gone there, you're going to get a decimal answer. So let's see what that is. 87 divided by 24 is 3.625. And what that says to me is that there's 3 whole days, and then there's some hours left over. It's not 6 hours left over or 6.625 hours left over, but I can say that this equals 3 days, and then I have a certain amount of hours left over, and I have to figure that out. Well, how many hours are there in 3 days? 3 days is 24 times 3, or 72. So I can, well, I had 87 hours, and I've taken out 72 of those hours, which means I have 15 hours left. So I have 3 days, 15 hours in 87 hours. All right, what about 4.5 gallons to pints? Well, I have 4.5 gallons. I don't have a direct conversion to pints, so I'm going to do this one in two steps like I did the other one. I'm going to first get rid of gallons and go to quarts. And there's 4 quarts in 1 gallon. Then I'm going to get rid of quarts, put that on the bottom, and I'm going to go to pints, which is what I was after. And there are 2 pints in 1 quart. Those conversions are given to me. So the gallons go and the quarts go, and that leaves the pints. And so I'm going to take 4.5 × 4 × 2, and that gives me 34 pints. All right, and finally, I have 9.5 cups to pints, cups, and ounces. And that's a little tricky. So let's look at that one. So I have 9.5 cups. And I want to go to, let's start with pints. I want to end up with pints. I want to get rid of the cups. And there's 2 cups in 1 pint. So the first thing I'm going to do is take 9.5 and divide by 2. You can do that off to the side, you can do it on your calculator, whatever you want. But it turns out to be 19 over 4, and I know my cups have canceled, so I'm talking about pints. But what I want to do is like what I did back here. How many times does 4 go into 19? Well, 4 goes into 19 4 times. 4 times 4 is 16, with 3 left over. So I have 4 and 3/4 pints. Well, I have 4 pints for sure, and then I have some stuff left. What is 3/4 of a pint if I want to think of that as cups? Well, I can go back and do this. I have 3/4 of a pint, and I want to change that into cups. So I have 2 cups is 1 pint, and if I multiply across, I get 3/2. Multiply and reduce, you get 3/2, 3/4 × 2. And that is cups. Well, that looks like 1.5 cups. So I have 1 cup. And then I still have 1/2 cup. What I know from my chart above is that 8 ounces is 1 cup. So if I have 1/2 cup, how many ounces would that be? That would be 4 ounces. So I have 4 ounces. So it's 4 pints, 1 cup, and 4 ounces. Now that one is tricky. You watch the video or go watch another one on YouTube, and you'll start to see how that works. All right, have a fantastic day.